Good evening. Welcome to the 153rd day of the Swasthya 365 Days project. Today we are going to see about the symptom and diagnosis and treatment of a seizure. Symptoms of a seizure. The person have various degrees of symptoms depending upon the type of the seizure. Following are the general symptoms or warning signs of a seizure. The symptoms include staring, jerking movements of arms and legs, stiffening of the body, loss of consciousness, breathing problems or breathing stops, loss of bowel or bladder control, falling suddenly or for no apparent reason, especially when associated with loss of consciousness, not responding to noise or words for brief words, appearing confused or in a haze, nodding the head rhythmically when associated with loss of awareness or even loss of consciousness, periods of rapid eye blinking and staring. During the seizures, the person's lips may become bluish and breathing may not be normal. The movements are often followed by a period of sleep and disorientation. The symptoms of a seizure may be resembled with other problems or medical conditions. Always consult a doctor for your diagnosis. How are seizures diagnosed? The full extent of a seizure may not be completely understood immediately after the onset of symptoms, but may be revealed with a comprehensive medical evaluation or diagnostic testing. The diagnosis of a seizure is made by a physical examination or diagnostic test. During examination, a doctor obtains a complete medical history of the person and family when he has an seizures occurred. Seizures may include neurological problems and require further medical follow-up. Diagnostic tests include blood test, electroencephalogram. Electroencephalogram is called as EEG, a procedure that records the brain's continuous electrical activity by means of electrodes attached to the scalp. Magnetic resonance imaging is called as MRI, a diagnostic procedure that uses a combination of large magnets and radio frequencies and a computer to produce detailed images of organs within the body. Computer tomography scan, called as CT scan or CAT scan, a diagnostic imaging procedure that uses a combination of X-rays and computer technology to produce horizontal and axial images of the body. A CT scan shows detailed images of the part of the body, including bones, muscles, fat and organs. CT scans are more detailed and general than X-rays. Positron emitted tomography, that's called as PET. PET scans use a small amount of low dose of radioactive material that is injected into a vein to help to visualize the areas of brain and direct abnormalities. Single photon emission computerized tomography, SPECT scan. This type of test is primarily if you have had an MRI and EEG that didn't pinpoint the location in your brain where the seizures are orienting. A SPECT test is used for a small amount of low dose of radioactive material that is injected into a vein to create a detailed 3D map of the blood flow activating in your brain systems. Doctors may also conduct a form of SPECT test that's called a subtraction ICTAL. SPCET considers MRI SICOM, which is intent to produce an even more detailed test. Neuropsychological test. In this test, doctor assess your thinking, memory and speech skills. The test results help the doctors determine which areas of brain are affected. Along with your test result, your doctor may use a combination of analysis techniques to help you pinpoint the brain seizure start. Statistical parametric mapping, that's called SPM. SPM is a method of comparing areas of brain that has increased metabolism during seizures to normal brains, which can give doctors an idea of when the seizures begin. Curry analysis. Curry analysis is a technique that takes EEG data and projects onto an MRI and brain to show the doctor's seizure occurring. Magnetoencephalography, that's called MEG. MEG and measures the magnetic field produced by brain activity to identify the potential areas of seizure onset. Lumbar puncture or spinal tap. A special needle is placed into the lower back, into the spinal canal, the area on the spinal cord. The pressure in the spinal canal and brain can be measured. Small amount of cerebrospinal fluid, that's called CSF, can be removed and sent for testing to determine whether the infection or other problems. CSF is the fluid that bathes the brain and spinal cord. Treatment of a seizure. Specific treatment for a seizure will be determined by a doctor based upon your age, overall health and medical history, type of seizures, frequency of seizures, your tolerance to specific medications, procedures and therapies, expectation of the course of the condition, your opinion or preference. The goal of seizure management is to control, stop and decrease the frequency of seizures without interfering with the normal activities of daily life. So it's called ADL. These major goals of seizure management include the following: proper identification of the type of seizure, using medication specific to type of seizure, using the least amount of medication to achieve adequate control, maintaining the appropriate medication levels. Treatment may include medications. There may be many types of medications used to treat seizures and epilepsy. Medications are selected based upon type of seizure, age of the patient and side of the effects and cost of medication and adherence to the use of medications. Medications used at home are taken in the form of capsules, tablets, sprinkles or syrup. But someone can intern reactively into a person's rectum. If the person is in turn hospital with seizures, medication may be given by injection or intravenously by IV, by an IV. It is important to take your medications on time and prescribed by your doctor. Different people use the medications to in their body differently, so adjustments, scheduled dosage may be done for the effective seizure control. All medications can have side effects, although some people may not experience certain side effects. Discuss your medication's possible side effects with your doctor while you are taking medications. Different tests may be done to monitor the effectiveness of the medication, as well as prognosis. This test may include the following: blood work. A frequent blood draws testing is usually required to check the level of the medications of the body. Based upon this level, the doctor may increase or decrease dosage to achieve the desired level. Urine test. The tests are sometimes performed to see how a body is responding to the medication. Electroencephalogram. The electroencephalogram is again a procedure to record the brain's continuous electrical activity by means of electrodes attached to the skull. This test is intended to monitor the medications and see the prognosis of the medication. Then you have nerve called vagus nerve. One of the medications includes a vagus nerve stimulation. Some people who have seizures are not well controlled with the seizure medications. They benefit by procedure called as vagus nerve stimulation. VNS is currently most common used for the people over age 12 who have partial seizures that can be controlled by other methods. VNS attempts to control seizures by sending a small pulses of energy to the brain from the vagus nerve, which is a large nerve in the back. This is done surgically by placing a small battery in the chest wall. Small wires are then attached into the battery and placed under the skin and around the vagus nerve. The battery is in turn programmed to send energy impulses very few minutes to the brain. When a person feels the seizure coming on, he or she may activate the impulses by holding a small magnet over the battery. In many cases, this will help to stop the seizure. There are some side effects that may occur during the use of VNS. This may include the hoarseness, pain or discomfort over the throat, and change in voice. Surgery. Another treatment option for seizure is surgery. Surgery may be considered in the person who having a seizures that is unable to control and medications, as seizures have started always start in one area of brain, as seizures in the part of brain that is removed without disrupting important behavior, speech, memory or vision. Surgery for epilepsy and seizures are very complicated and performed by specialized surgical team. The operation may remove the part of the brain where seizures are occurring, or sometimes the surgery helps to stop the spread of bad electrical currents to the brain. The person may be awake during the surgery. The brain itself does not feel pain. With the person awake and able to follow commands, surgeon will be able to make sure that the important areas of the brain are not damaged. Surgery is not an option for everyone with seizures. Discuss the treatment option with the doctor for more information. Thank you.